Good afternoon, Ma'am Brand. Good afternoon, Jose.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Sir, ikaw ako i-host, ha?
Ah, sige, ma'am.
Sige, bye-bye.
New home. Payag-Payag is a virtual space for artists, creators, and designers to come as they are to create and consume art products. It started for the Institutional Management Enterprise students of Philippine Women's College as a platform for them to practice their enterprising skills and showcase their art and products while promoting safer, more compliant, and convenient means of selling. It is a venue for the promotion and selling of handcrafted and chosen products from Filipino artists and designers. Let us all be a part of this community of creatives which share the goal of reaching a bigger scale for products that are truly Filipino-made. This is Payag-Payag, to agree to a new home. Payag-Payag is a virtual space for artists, creators, and designers to come as they are to create and consume art products. It started for the Institutional Management Enterprise students of Philippine Women's College as a platform for them to practice their enterprising skills and showcase their art and products while promoting safer, more compliant, and convenient means of selling. It is a venue for the promotion and selling of handcrafted and chosen products from Filipino artists and designers. Let us all be a part of this community of creatives which share the goal of reaching a bigger scale for products that are truly Filipino-made. This is Payag-Payag, to agree to a new home. Payag-Payag is a virtual space for artists, creators, and designers to come as they are to create and consume art products. It started for the Institutional Management Enterprise students of Philippine Women's College as a platform for them to practice their enterprising skills and showcase their art and products while promoting safer, more compliant, and convenient means of selling. It is a venue for the promotion and selling of handcrafted and chosen products from Filipino artists and designers. Let us all be a part of this community of creatives which share the goal of reaching a bigger scale for products that are truly Filipino-made. This is Payag-Payag, to agree to a new home. Payag-Payag is a virtual space for artists, creators, and designers to come as they are to create and consume art products. It started for the Institutional Management Enterprise students of Philippine Women's College as a platform for them to practice their enterprising skills and showcase their art and products while promoting safer, more compliant, and convenient means of selling. It is a venue for the promotion and selling of handcrafted and chosen products from Filipino artists and designers. Let us all be a part of this community of creatives which share the goal of reaching a bigger scale for products that are truly Filipino made. This is Payag Payag, to agree to a new home.
Before we start our launching, may we remind all attendees of the following guidelines. When attending meetings, orientation, and the like, it is expected that all attendees should observe punctuality, and the following simple reminders and etiquette will be followed. First, mute your microphone. To help keep background noise to a minimum, make sure you mute your microphone when you are not speaking. Be mindful of background noise and activities. When your microphone is not muted, avoid activities that could create additional noise, such as walking, lying down, talking with friends, or watching movies. Position your camera properly. If you choose to use a web camera, be sure it is in a stable position and focus at eye level. If possible, doing this can help create a more direct sense of engagement with the other participants. No showing of legs or body. Focus the camera to your face. Limit distractions. You can make it easier to focus on the meeting by turning off notifications, closing or minimizing running apps, and muting your smartphone. Avoid multitasking. You can retain the discussion better if you refrain from replying to emails or text messages during the meetings or events, and wait to work on it until after the meeting ends. Use headsets if there are distractions. This is to avoid unnecessary noise whenever. However, if there are no disturbances within your area, using a headset is not important. Use raise hand icon. This icon is used when participants or attendees want to speak or have questions to clarify the matters. Use the chat box. This is used to type one's questions or clarifications if the participant does not want to speak. Dress appropriately. Consider that all events and meetings called by PwC are official. Wear something that is suitable for a meeting or events, or that looks good on the participants. Not to dress without sleeves, spaghetti straps, etc. Show your face if signal is okay. This is a sign of courtesy and respect. Everyone is eager to see one's face, especially during this lockdown. Be mindful of the meeting or activity that is going on. Everyone is expected to listen and stay with the said meeting or activity until it ends. Lastly, if there are noises and other distractions during the meeting or activity, the host or co-hosts will do any of the following: mute your microphone or disable your video camera. Please be guided accordingly. Thank you. Now, to officially begin our program, we will have an opening prayer and a pambansang awit.
Ang nabuhat sa kalimutan. A'udzu billahi minasyaitonir rajim. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Faqala rabbukum ud'uni astajib lakum. Amin ya rabbal alamin. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin arrahmanir rahim maliki yaumiddin. Iyyaka na'budu wa iyyaka nasta'in ihdinas siratal mustaqim. Siratal ladzina an'amta 'alaihim ghairil maghdubi 'alaihim waladdallin. Amin. Allahumma ajma shamal al-muslimin wa kristian wa lumad bi madinat Dabaw. وسلم دائما مجتمعنا هذا بالسلم والأمن والتقدم في بلدنا هذا آمين يا رب العالمين ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب ربنا إنك أنت الوهاب ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وصلى الله على خير خلقه سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين آمين يا رب العالمين.
In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Our most gracious Heavenly Father, we come to you today to praise and worship you and give you thanks for all the things you continue to provide for ourselves and our families. Father, we humbly ask for forgiveness for all the times we have offended you, when we forget to acknowledge your presence in the image of our brothers and sisters, and for moments we fail to be good stewards of the blessings you have given us. Continue to guide and protect each one of us, Lord, that we may always walk in the light of your everlasting love and mercy. Grant us, Father, with your comfort in times of distress and with your strength in times of weakness. Bestow upon us your unending grace and healing, that we in turn become instruments of gentleness and compassion to others. We ask all this in the name of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, with a prayer and the intercession of our Blessed Mother. Amen.
Oh,
To help us welcome, we have the Chancellor and VP for Administration and Academics, Chancellor Vicente Antonio V. Pijano III, with his pre-recorded message. Let's watch this.
To the administrators, members of the faculty, students, artists, and guests. First of all, let me take this opportunity to welcome you to the first ever Virtual Art Museum, hosted by the Helena Benitez School of Fine Arts and Design. This is a very important event since we, in the middle of the pandemic, still continue to host this annual event that we normally host in Apriza Mall. This is indeed a very important activity because it allows us to make our students practice whatever they've learned in the classroom and bring them to the outside world and to share it with everyone, and also working with the various communities that we are partnered with. During this time of the pandemic, it is very important that we continue doing the activities that we used to do, because it allows us to show that we are continuing and we have not let the virus win in this battle that we are currently encountering. What is important in this activity is that we wanted to make sure that the Helena Benitez School of Fine Arts and Design continues on how it envisions itself as the cradle of Mindanao's evolving creative identity and economy. Its mission is to produce globally competitive and enterprising artists and designers. So I would like to congratulate everyone who had really continued this tradition, this hard work to enable this activity to happen. I am very thankful for your hard work, and again, congratulations to all your efforts. Good luck and have a wonderful day.
Thank you so much, Chancellor Pijano, for that very warm welcome. At this point, let us all listen for the opening remarks we have by Mr. Glindon Caupano A. Laureano, the Institutional Management Enterprise Head.
To our Chancellor and Chief Operating Officer, Professor Vicente Antonio V. Pijano III, Academic Cluster Director of FAID, Ma'am Brenda Z. Barba, Head of Center for Innovation and Social Venture, Sir Emmy Alexander L. Inglis, our dear guest speakers, faculty, event attendees, good afternoon. It is my privilege and pleasure to be a part of this event today, the first virtual art market, and also the launching of the Payag-Payag, their social media platform. Now, this event is being organized by the Institutional Management Enterprise class under the Helena Z. Benitez School of Fine Arts and Design of Philippine Women's College of Davao. As the Institutional Management Enterprise Coordinator, I'd like to give you a brief background on the Institutional Management Enterprise, or acronym as IME. It is actually a course which was created with a specific goal of promoting locally produced products and services, primarily through the efforts of the tertiary education students and mentors. It is also a safe space for students to apply their knowledge and skills in creating and operating an enterprise for social impact. Now, the first virtual art market is one of the outputs of the students under the IME program, where the highlights of this year's event is to launch a virtual platform for local artists, designers, and crafters to come together through a selling exhibition and supplier interface. As we officially open this event, I hope and pray that everyone would enjoy in participating and that networks and opportunities would be open for our local artists, designers, and suppliers. May you all have a wonderful day ahead of you.
Thank you so much, Mr. Glyndon, for that very warm message and welcoming to your students and the stakeholders of this event. At this point, we will witness our first speaker. He is a graduate of Fashion Design in Philippine Women's College of Davao, where he reinvented the traditional garment of the Bagobo Tagabawa using technology in a contemporary ensemble, winning the first I Am Stellar, a prestigious fashion design competition. This skyrocketed him to become one of the finalists of the 2017's Bench Design Awards. Fast forward to now, he has designed numerous looks for Catriona Gray and many more stars. Here is a pre-recorded talk of the creative director of Nino Franco himself, Mr. Wilson Nino Franco Limon.
I am Wilson Limon. I am the creative director of Nino Franco. Niño Franco is a thesis-based clothing line where we incorporate the traditional craftsmanship of the various ethno-linguistic communities in the Philippines. So it started year 2014 when I was working on my thesis for the Philippine Women's College. So I was assigned to do a research about the Bagobo Tagapawa. So then I went to the foothills of Mount Apo to interview the Bagobo weaver Vivencia Mamites. And from there, I've seen the beauty of their craftsmanship and I was deeply inspired to help them sustain their livelihood. So we thought on focusing on contemporary pieces because it's a good way of helping them to sustain the craftsmanship. And as a creative director, I think that I can contribute, especially on preserving the culture. Being in the fashion industry is a great challenge for us because number one, it's something that has been hardly stopped by the pandemic and we are in a non-essential industry. But then I think that we have to help them. We have to help our partner communities by creating pieces that is very timely in this time of the pandemic. So what we have done is that we created the Massive Hope campaign. We produced different kinds of masks with artisanal craftsmanship. So with our campaign, we were able to help them sustain their livelihood and we were able to donate a percentage of the proceeds to our partner communities. And we also started selling the artisanal scrub suits. And then we also gained support from the doctors, and which we were also able to help our partner communities. I think my advice would be find something that you love to do. And of course, you have to work hard, so you'll get good at it. As a fashion designer, as a creative director, the most important thing is to look for your core aesthetic, because that is what makes you a true designer or a true creative director. You have to know your aesthetic that separates you from the other designers or the other creatives. And of course, you have to be patient because you can't be successful overnight. So it's a long process, it's a long journey. And yeah, I think that you all just have to be patient and optimistic. Get to know more of our brand, visit www.niñofrancoph.com and our Instagram at niñofranco.ph. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Mr. Limon, for that message and your points on creating a specific brand, knowing yourself, and staying creative. Now, for our next speaker, he is Wilfred Dexter G. Tanyedo, a former PwC Program Chair for Painting and Visual Communication, and currently manages Larencia Davao for Gutierrez Development Corporation Co. Incorporated. He is also a DepEd consultant for the Arts and Education Program and also known as the artist Rob Tanyedo.
Hi everyone, I'm Rob. Hi everyone, I'm Rob Tanyedo from La Regencia Davao Arts and Events Pavilion. I also work for Gutierrez Development Company Incorporated, which is owned by my family. I'm also a visual artist and a former art educator. Though I have not really left the art education, I still do certain works like doing curriculum and also doing book reviews regarding the art program that we have. So what is being a creative during the time of pandemic? I will return that question with a question. Is there a difference for a creative during the pandemic? I mean, there is even this comic strip that shows an artist really unaffected by the pandemic, because you know what? Creatives still do their work regardless of what things are happening, because what do creatives do? They do something, they create something. So maybe some opportunities were lost during the pandemic, but it's not much the loss of the industry in itself. What it did is actually create another platform for the creatives to be able to come up with something new, to be able to sell their work or to showcase their whatever creative outputs that they have. So if there's something that the creative did do to us, is that it gave us an opportunity to come up with a new platform. And this platform is actually what we're doing right now, which is an online thing, right? Who knew even education will be heavily be affected, and yet we did not forgo it and really pursued it even in an online way. So what it did, we were able to find a platform, the work continued, we may have lost a little, but we are also gaining a lot. Actually, quite recently, we opened an exhibit here in our place in La Regencia, which is actually a hybrid. I think you can no longer have a gallery set up wherein you are just stuck to a particular place. You have to always go virtual to let people know. I mean, in our first 2 days of opening, we have already a total of more or less 40 guests. And most of them came in only because we advertised through the social media. And that's a big thing. And from that visit that they came here, I was able to do several sales already of some of the works exhibited. Okay, so another thing that we need to put in mind, that being a creative, we are not limited really by the situation that happens around us. And we are not also bounded by time, because our work would always be something that keep us moving. I mean, no time, no pandemic will stop us from doing our work. Maybe it will change a little because we are really also very much adaptable as a creative, but it does not mean that it stops or it's dying or it's not going to be there. So if there's something that I could give to you are these things. Number one, there's nothing really changed. Kahit may pandemic, we are able to do our work. Number two, it opened to us new opportunities to the platforms that are already there. Now we are maximizing it. So you see, it's just really finding the opportunity. And number three, we are never bounded by the things around us. Being a creative, we always find ways and means to be able to do what we do, because that keeps us alive, that keeps us sane. And why is being creative important during the time of the pandemic? Number one, it's also a mover of the economy. I think one of the movers of the economy is the creative, because we can work at home. We are, again, not affected by the pandemic. We could send out our works even online. We could sell even online. So things like that. Also, things that we've learned also during the pandemic is that we are able to help out other people. I mean, with the arts, that's the other aspect of being a creative. We inspire people to do the art so that they self-help themselves. Ito yung tinatawag natin art healing or art therapy. So one way to distress ourselves from the things that is happening around us. So it may not lead to a particular selling of work, but for us, it's something personal. And that's the thing that is important also during this time of pandemic, that we distress ourselves, we stop for a little, and then do things that makes us happy. And I think art is one of those things that makes us happy, because it's really personal. Okay? So I hope with this very brief talk that I gave you an idea of what it means to be a creative during the pandemic. And be inspired to continue.
Thank you, Sir Rob, for that very inspiring message. He talked about how there is still opportunity and that the work still continues, and even probably there are more work for the creatives out there. There is a vast opportunity at the palm of your hands. So I hope that all of our participants grab on these opportunities and really work on their passion. At this point, we would like to thank the following brands and designers for collaborating with us. We would like to thank Alud, Bygones, Daily Dally, EduCraft, Exi. Foxy Lashes by Seth. Interior Design. Karga Bags. Cosmo Chaos. Sagang by Stephen Azarcon. Stacy. Vine Castle. And Visual Communication. We're giving you all a sneak peek for what we're releasing in the next few weeks via Allude. Bygones. EduCraft by the Education Cluster. Foxy Lashes by Seth. Home Decor by the Interior Design Cluster. Cosmos Chaos. And Sagang. So I would like to greet all of our 67 participants here in the Zoom call and all our viewers there on Facebook Live. I hope you guys are doing well and excited for this Bayag Bayag launching. Okay, also, I hope you don't forget to follow the social medias of Bayag Bayag on Instagram, Facebook, and TikTok. Their details are seen on screen. Once again, I'm inviting everyone to follow the social medias of Bayag Bayag on Instagram, Facebook, and TikTok. And now, we will begin with our launching.
Bayag Bayag is a virtual space for artists, creators, and designers to come as they are to create and consume art products. It started for the Institutional Management Enterprise students of Philippine Women's College as a platform for them to practice their enterprising skills and showcase their art and products while promoting safer, more compliant, and convenient means of selling. It is a venue for the promotion and selling of handcrafted and chosen products from Filipino artists and designers. Let us all be a part of this community of creatives which share the goal of reaching a bigger scale for products that are truly Filipino made. This is Bayag Bayag, to agree to a new home. Bayag Bayag is a virtual space for artists, creators, and designers to come as they are to create and consume art products. It started for the Institutional Management Enterprise students of Philippine Women's College as a platform for them to practice their enterprising skills and showcase their art and products while promoting safer, more compliant, and convenient means of selling. It is a venue for the promotion and selling of handcrafted and chosen products from Filipino artists and designers. Let us all be a part of this community of creatives which share the goal of reaching a bigger scale for products that are truly Filipino made. This is Bayag Bayag, to agree to a new home. Payag-Payag is a virtual space for artists, creators, and designers to come as they are to create and consume art products. It started for the Institutional Management Enterprise students of Philippine Women's College as a platform for them to practice their enterprising skills and showcase their art and products while promoting safer, more compliant, and convenient means of selling. It is a venue for the promotion and selling of handcrafted and chosen products from Filipino artists and designers. Let us all be a part of this community of creatives which share the goal of reaching a bigger scale for products that are truly Filipino-made. This is Payag-Payag, to agree to a new home.
Before we end, we would like to welcome Mrs. Brenda Barba, the Fine Arts and Interior Design Academic Cluster Director.
Good afternoon. Our Chancellor, Mr. Tito Piano, our admin, faculty of the Fine Arts Department, our PWC community, students, I am so happy and really proud of the Fine Arts Department, especially the Helena Z. Benitez School of Fine Arts and Culture. At this point, I would like to also congratulate those who have initiated on this IMC under the flagship of Mr. Emmy Englis. It only started before as a thesis and research, and now it is a very, very successful endeavor. We have already used our vision, mission, and goals, and it was really very successful. We have also helped and gave identity and recognition to our Mindanaoan traits. Our artists and designers are really a big help also to you, dear students of the fine arts. Now, as I close this, may I say, congratulations to all the fine arts, especially those who were behind this program. Thank you and have a very pleasant good afternoon.
Thank you so much, Ma'am Barba, for that wonderful message. At this point, we will have a presentation of the certificates for the speakers. And then I may read the citations of the certificates. So for our speakers, we will send their certificates on their emails. So thank you so much.
Payag-Payag is a virtual space for artists, creators, and designers to come as they are to create and consume art products. It started for the Institutional Management Enterprise students of Philippine Women's College as a platform for them to practice their enterprising skills and showcase their art and products while promoting safer, more compliant, and convenient means of selling. It is a venue for the promotion and selling of handcrafted and chosen products from Filipino artists and designers. Let us all be a part of this community of creatives which share the goal of reaching a bigger scale for products that are truly Filipino-made. This is Payag-Payag, to agree to a new home. Payag-Payag is a virtual space for artists, creators, and designers to come as they are to create and consume art products. It started for the Institutional Management Enterprise students of Philippine Women's College as a platform for them to practice their enterprising skills and showcase their art and products while promoting safer, more compliant, and convenient means of selling. It is a venue for the promotion and selling of handcrafted and chosen products from Filipino artists and designers. Let us all be a part of this community of creatives which share the goal of reaching a bigger scale for products that are truly Filipino-made. This is Payag-Payag, to agree to a new home.
And with that, we are officially ending our launching. And once again, I invite all of our participants to follow the Payag-Payag socials on TikTok, Facebook, and Instagram. You may select all the items that you want, glance on the things you may be interested in. All right, so make sure you don't leave this Zoom call without following them on their socials. All right, I hope. Let's give ourselves a big thumbs up. If we've followed them, we'd like to give a big support to our wonderful schoolmates who have created and made this payag-payag.dvo possible. All right, so let's get that thumbs up if you've followed them. And if you have, then you may now leave the Zoom call. Once again, I encourage and invite you all to follow the socials of Payag-Payag Davao. There are a lot of things you can glance into, something that you're interested in. Maybe you could order the next time, right? A big support. As we say, we should support local and at the same time support our classmates, our friends. I hope that you support them outside this launching and through all out of their endeavors. We're good? Yes. So I can see a few people leaving. I believe those amazing people already have followed our socials. And to our Facebook viewers as well. Since you're already in Facebook, hit that follow, hit that like page. And if you're generous too, you can also do some sharing and some commenting on the pics and the posts that the Payag-Payag Davao already have posted. I hope you also invite your friends, your family to look into the different things that they are selling there. Maybe it could be something you can use as a gift. Or a gift to yourself also, right? So once again, I'd like to say thank you to everyone who are part of this launching, to those who participated, and to the organizers as well. A big congratulations to them also. Once again, you may leave the Zoom call once you followed them on your socials. They are on TikTok, on Facebook, and on Instagram. Make sure to check out their items, the stuff that they're selling. You can easily message them for any inquiries and questions you may have. Thank you so much for your time, and I hope all of you have a great afternoon ahead.